What a piece of junk.
Hi, we're back. And we're back with issue number 16 of Build the Millennium Falcon. What has happened in the past 15 weeks? We had a break at week 4. But we're back on track now with issue 16. Let's see what we got in issue 16. Information about the YT-1760 small transport, which is a ship which, as far as I know, did not appear in any movies, but I believe it is part of the comic books and gaming side of Star Wars lore. Not that really interesting, actually. Hoth Ice Fields, information about Hoth and the snowtroopers over there. And now we come to the Falcon's layout. This is one of the several times we get a picture of the inside of Millennium Falcon. Well, this is actually the inside of the YT-1300 FP, which is a standard configuration. As Han Solo said, he did a lot of modifications himself. And most notably, of course, is, well, this is the big one. And we here can see this is the Millennium Falcon inside. And here we have the next parts, which will include sections of the corridor, which I was just talking about. Part of the hull frame and screws, of course, and the corridor rings. Okay, and let's take a look now at the parts for issue 16, shall we? Okay, what we got? We have part of the hull plating. We'll be getting a lot of these, of course. We have part of the hull frame, which we're probably gonna fix later. We have the infamous little paper, and that goes wee! That goes away. We have some screws. Just make sure that these are separate, because these are actually different screws. You know how I was talking about an issue 15? How I was screwed? And three black screws. Well, those are the standard screws we already have. And here we have the floor and the bottom section of the corridor, which eventually is going to be going over here. So, issue 16. Yes, let me first lay the parts away a bit. We're going to need the frame and the hull plating we're going to use later. So we're going to leave that aside. And we're going to concentrate on this. This is the hallway and the screws. And I have to be certain that these are different screws like the one we used earlier. So I'll probably put these in its package in one of those jars I got, because I spoke last week of the different screws. These are the screws which are to be used for the corridors to screw together. And these look like the brass screws we had last week, but they are different. So I'll put them aside just to be sure. These are the standard black screws. There's nothing different about these. So I can put these in the jar with the other black screws. I got three of them, so I'm probably going to use only two and get one as a spare, which is always useful. Here they are. Okay, so let's close up this jar before something bad happens. So at least all my screws are now secured in its jars and I can't lose them. Right, the floor and the bottom section of one of the corridors. This, I believe, is going to be going to the access to the cockpit, and this is going to go to the turrets, and this floor is going to go in here. But no, we're not going to do that. This box I was talking about last week, what is in this box? Well, let me open it. I've already opened it last week, of course, but let me reopen it for you again. This is a set from Paragraphics. I have worked with these people in the past. They make photo-etched parts for several kits, different kits. And for the Falcon, they have several additional kits made. One of them is the floor for the main hold, and that I did not buy. But I couldn't go past this. These are the floors for the corridor. And as you can see, here we have this section over here. and this is the same as this floor. Now you may already see some differences. First of all, there are two holes in here. These are in fact the holes where Han Solo and Luke and the others hit while they were beamed aboard the Death Star, with several separate plates, so you can actually choose to either put them on permanently, we can use these plates for that, or you can use these plates and you can set them aside so they look like they're opened. And if they're open, I of course need to do something about the area underneath, because otherwise you're going to see this. And talking about area underneath, you may also see that there are, can I see that on the camera? Let me. There are also tiny little slots along the floor of the corridors. These are not present on the model, on the plastic. These slots, I can light them, because in the studio model, these slots have lights underneath. And here we come to a slight problem. If we're going to put lights underneath, how, what are we going to do about these holes? I have to figure that out later, because I'm definitely going to light the corridor floors. And in order to do that, I will need to remove these plastic lips around the plastic floors. There are several other things included in this kit, like these circles over here. These are the lights which are going to go in the corridors, which you can also light, of course. And these little things are detailed door buttons, which are not in the kit, but you can put them in. And we could put these decals behind it, which you can also light up, so you have lit up door controls. So, first thing we have to do is first take a look about, take a look, of course, in the original instruction manual, which suggests to fit the floor corridor and then screw it secure. And we have to completely negate this. We have to first modify the floor and then see how we're going to fit lights underneath. Then we're going to have to fit the floor onto this plastic and find a way to get these holes visible. And if I won't be able to do that, then I can just glue in the plates and we just call it even, we just call it quits. So that is what we're going to do right now. And the rest of the construction concerns the these corridor loops, hoops. Well, I need to have this finished first before I can actually install these three hoops. So let's go modify the floor. I have already cut out the holes where the hiding places are going to go, and I removed one of the sections over here for the lights. Not completely finished yet, but oops, sorry. How I did this, I first tried to drill four holes over here, which will allow me to cut out the cut the lines using a knife. But that took me a long time, so I had to drill small holes all over here, and that took a really long time. So then I tried this device by making cuts all over this and over there, and that also worked. Now about these sections here, I made small cuts because I need to make sure that there is some plastic staying over here, because that is where these corridor rings are going to go. So I can't remove them completely. So what I did was, as I said, I made some cuts with the knife, and let me turn on my drill, my little handy dandy. Oh.
Okay, now I need to remove this section between those lines. And the best thing to do that is by cutting it over here. Be very careful not to break off these lines.
Okay. Now the plastic has been melting a bit, but not to worry. I just used the knife and cut off the melted plastic. And there we go. Probably need a file to sand it off a bit. But what I've now created, and allow me to show you what I've done. So here's the photo etch part, and need to find the correct position. So now I need to put in the ring, which will then still fit. Oh, but the light will be able to penetrate through the little holes. And I have to do the entire thing step by step. Even though the instructions suggest you can wait until episode 18 because you are going to install several of these frames simultaneously, I still want to add this frame right now. This is frame number BF19, and it's supposed to go, not over there, it's supposed to go, turn this around, supposed to go over here. Yeah, that's right, it's one over here. Okay, I need three screws. I need those black ones. Did I say three? No, I need two. Do I? Let's see. No, I need only two screws. Okay, let's see if we can actually get these screws to stick. And I also see that I really need to clean up my desk, because each episode, of course, this frame is going to get larger and larger, and there's going to be a moment when this frame is no longer going to fit on this desk. So I believe that I need to, this is the last piece of frame actually I can add to this existing frame until I clean up the desk. Well, that's it. That's all there is to it. The observant viewer will also see that I've removed all the hole plating at the moment. Yes, I could have let them stay on. Yes, they would enhance the stability, and yes, I could actually screw some of them on. But since the adding of all the frames is going to be done in a single episode, in this, I'm gonna wait until that episode actually comes along, this that issue, and then we're gonna stick and screw all the plates on, and then we have the entire finished bottom section of the Falcon. And that's the last of the cushions. Well, I got a lot of them right now. Three complete sprues with cushions, all of them removed. And now, joy upon joy, I have to sand all of them before I can actually attach them to these rings. So I have already stuck on the photo etch flooring of the Falcon onto the plastic floor, which is going to be going into this tube. I have tested how paint reacts on the photo etch part. It stays on all right, but I have read that several people suggest that you soak this in vinegar for about an hour. Maybe I'm going to try that. Eventually, of course, I'm going to use an airbrush to spray paint the floor. I have already concocted a color for that. Just like I did with the hole color, I have, the color for the hold, I have called this corridor, which is a combination of black, metallic, and a little bit of that blue I used for the holes, and it results in a metallic dark gray looking color. I've already brushed a few color strokes of color on that part, because eventually we're going to use the cushions onto this, but just to test it out. And I have already painted the rings in those get color, all three of them. I of course need to paint the cushions, but I would like to wait by painting before painting these cushions, because there are going to be a lot of these rings in further issues, and I would like to paint them all in the same light brown color. So I will paint the rings and the metallic sections of the rings. I will not glue in the rings yet. I will wait until I have all rings ready for paint and then glue them in. I need to wait anyway, because you are supposed to place in the floor and then screw in the floor. I am not going to do that either, because as I said earlier, I want to put some lights underneath, and I would like to wait until all the corridor rings are ready for the light strips to be installed, and then install all the floors. Plus I need to see what happens with these holes, because I probably need to do something about it, otherwise you can't see the lights coming through the holes. Last thing I need to do, there is a piece of plastic here which is going to go inside the holes. Let me show you by getting the holes over here. It goes, let's see if you can actually see it on camera. It goes on in here, as you can see. And can you see from the other side? Hold on. Let me turn it around so you can see it. Yes. Oh, there it is. Okay. And there is a step, as you can see, a lip which goes on the floor. Now, I need to remove this lip, and the reason is because there's another photo etch part which goes onto that lip, and that is also going to be lighted. And in order to do so, let me show you on the photo in the instructions. It actually is this lip, which is, as you can see, lighted. So I'm now going to remove the rest of the lip, at least for the floor section, and I'm going to use this sander. Let's see where do I put the indications. Over here. Okay, that took some planning on how to actually tackle this. Okay, now I need to use a knife to clean up all the melted pieces of plastic. And then I'm going to see if I actually cut off enough. Okay, let's see if the part will fit. It's going to go... Be very careful not to bend it, because it's very easily to be bended. Yes, it is going to go over here. Can you see it? It's going to go over here. So, I need to fix off this hole, of course, and the top hole. But it will fit, and all I need to do is clean it up, stick it on, paint it, and make sure there are no additional light leaks. And hey presto! After a failed attempt, because I unfortunately made cuts over here when I actually was supposed to make cuts over there, so this can go. I made another one, and if you want to know what this is, well, this is, and I was going to go over here. Let me get into position. this is going to be the new wall section for the hold, as you can see. And this is the continuing section where the floor has been extended over here. So I needed to extend the wall too, and it'll fit perfectly. Of course, now it is bright white, so I need to paint this. Right, let's get this thing painted. Right, so this is the back section which I've cut out of here. I still kept it. And this is a piece of scrap plastic I cut from the floor of the corridor because it's the same height. I used this scrap piece of plastic to screw in this groove. This is part of the construction which was supposed to go over there. And I have already placed it in this piece of plastic which I spray painted. Unfortunately, I thought I had to cut out a strip over here for this wall section, but I made a mistake. The wall is supposed to go over here, so oops. So this is going to go over here. I already added a few pieces of plastic so this floor can sit on that. And you may notice all these masking tape which is put on, that has been used to draw on a pattern, because this is where the bunk bed is going to go, and this is a square which I have to cut out and then mask off with several pieces of styrene, because this is where the lights are going to go, because there is also some light coming through this hole spreading all over the floor of the main hold. Well, I need to cut out, of course, now these shapes and then sand them. And that is going to take some time.